according to sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please Him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what He did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I would bring him into full remission immediately. us to tell the Father what we need, and we will hear answers, and we'll be answered. But all too often, I think that we expect things to be done our way, instead of trusting the providence of God, our Father, who does love us more than even our fathers on earth could love us. Because God has the best interest of all of us in mind. Now, I'm not trying to negate the notion of praying for miracles. I've seen miracles. But that's not always the way in which God answers the prayers that we have. We can look around this world and see lots of places where we think God should be intervening. And that's what brings us to our parables today. So we have two of these very memorable parables. Anyone who's ever tried to grow a crop of grass in their yard knows what I'm talking about. You know, you go out and you scatter the seed and you hope it's going to grow. And you hope. You hope some more. You watch your water bill and you hope some more. And eventually you start to see little grass coming up, right? I do have a question for God. Why is it that the weeds grow faster than the grass? I want to know that. But nonetheless, when we look at the grass and this parable of the seeds growing, we recognize that God is the one who makes the crops grow. But we have a role. If you look carefully at the parable, he's telling us that things happen on the way that he wants them to happen, but that we have a role to play too. We have to scatter the seeds of good news. We must be the ones who are scattering God's word so that he can fertilize it, water it, and cause it to grow. We can't make it grow. God doesn't call us to necessarily be successful as a whole, but instead be faithful. And so we must always find ourselves in that mode of scattering the seeds that have been entrusted to us. So you'll notice that in that role, though, we have to be active. It's not that we accidentally scatter seed. He tells us to gratuitously scatter seed everywhere. And that's exactly what he's done in this first parable. Sow the seeds. You and I have been given that job. I would say that when I look around and I watch the news and listen to the discussion, I think the world is in great drought right now for the gospel. Going back to my lawn, last year was pretty well dead. And we seeded it. There's still some dead patches. Time to go back and find those spots where we need to sow the seeds again. It's not our job to question why the dead patches are there. Our job is to scatter the seeds of the gospel. So we can look at the dead patches around us as problems, or we can look at them as opportunities that are given to us by God to share in his mission. Right? So if you look around you right now, there are a lot of empty seeds right here in our area right now. You can look at that and say that's a problem. Or you can look at that and say that's fertile ground in which we have an opportunity to spread the seeds of the gospel. What are you doing to bring people into the four walls of the church when you're outside of the four walls of the church? Are you spreading the seeds of the gospel? Are you spreading the charity and love? Are you demonstrating to people what it means to be a Christian? Because that's what we're attracting people to come and join us. Now, the second parable relates a lot to this first parable. It's the parable of the mustard seed. We hear about it being the smallest seed and growing into a great bush. Well, Jesus is trying to tell us, again, through these parables, the mystery of the kingdom of God. It's so hard to describe, yet to describe lots of parables. Well, in this one, he's telling us the seed of the kingdom is so small. 12 men, armed with the Holy Spirit, went out and grew the church. And it continues to grow. There's a lot more than 12 of us here today. We are armed with that same Holy Spirit for our baptism and our confirmation. We go out and grow the church. That's our job. We have faith in God to help us in that mission. That's what we're called to do. Now, a tree, anybody who's ever planted a tree knows the things. You don't just plant a tree, even a seed, let alone a seedling, and just have it grow into a great tree overnight. What God is telling us is that it takes time for the church to grow. The kingdom of God will spread out slowly over time. But most importantly, what he tells us is this. He tells us that it will provide shade and shelter for all of us. Now, oftentimes we can get caught up in looking for the shade and the shelter, but sometimes, remember, the church is made of us. We are the church. We need to provide that aid and protection and shelter for others. When we go to our challenges in our lives, we should be looking at others for help. And when we have strength in those times in our life, we can provide shelter for others. We need to do that. I'll give you an example. About 8 years ago, my wife went with cancer. And at that time, we prayed to God for a miracle. We prayed for maybe a wrong diagnosis or a sudden healing. But instead, God said, you know what? That isn't the way that I'm going to have this healing take place. And it was through a lot of the shelter of people in this parish, our friends and family, and of course, great doctors and nurses that took care of us, that she came to believe one. And praise God that it has not come back over the last 8 years. When we look, though, at that time, I sure wanted that sudden instantaneous God I want to hear from right now. But why is it that God didn't answer it that way? It's a mystery to me. But what I can tell you is this. God loves us as a father. For those of you who are fathers, we take great joy in helping our kids with this. We take great joy in seeing our kids grow. We take great joy in helping them with their projects. And even though sometimes we are saddened by the things that happen to them, it is great love that is poured out when we sit with a child when they're having a bad day or when they're having a really, really bad experience in life. There's something to be drawn out of that love experience. So God calls us to sit with those who are also struggling with things. We are to be that shelter of the great mustard seed for those who are coming to help. You know, mustard seed grows into this tree that shelters the birds and the animals. Where do they go during the storm? Hiding in the tree for comfort and spirit. We are to do that as well. So God calls us to share His joy. It makes Him full of great joy when we come with our needs and He's able to heal us. He wants to share that joy. So when we are able to sit with someone in their struggles and in their times of trouble, we are sharing that joy. There's something absolutely wonderful about being able to sit with someone who can offer you nothing in return but to just be with them when they're in your time of trouble. There's great joy in that, and God calls us into that as well. He asks us to share in His name. And if you're not quite sure what to do, just share. Just be with someone. It's a good start. God will take care of the rest. Well, St. Augustine says, work as though everything depends on you, and pray as though everything depends on God. So it is my hope for you to be able to truly encounter somebody who definitely needs the love of God. So spread the seed of the gospel. Be joy for those who need joy. And sow the seeds of love. So don't worry about how the gospel will grow. Just be faithful and sow the seeds. Lord, and God will take care of us.
Please stand, and together let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father of all, maker of heaven and earth, and all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God, God, light and light, true God, begotten, not made, unspeakable. Amen.
for our Holy Father, that his prayers for Christian unity and renewal be fulfilled. We praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our president, governor, mayor, members of Congress, and all elected officials, that the Holy Spirit inspire and strengthen them in their service.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our earthly fathers, that they be courageous in raising their children with love, hope, joy, and strong Christian values. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those oppressed by any kind of need, that the Lord graciously grant them relief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an outpouring of Holy Spirit upon St. Louis PNC Parish. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
They have departed into the life of dwelling place, including Tom Cohen, Coleman, and Michael Boldy, that they may gaze upon you for all eternity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions listed in our parish book of prayer, and for all of the intentions we hold in silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, hear our voices when we call to you. Please grant answers to our prayers. We ask this through Christ our Lord.